My name is Jordan Jimenez, otherwise known as J Squared. I'm a freelance photographer from the Bay Area. So I actually started photography when I was a senior in high school. Wasn't really playing basketball anymore. All I was really doing was just like school, work, all the extracurriculars. And I kind of figured that I needed something new to do. So for whatever reason, I was just kind of drawn to a camera and, you know, just picked it up, went out with some friends, like walking around San Francisco, you know, climbing on rooftops and everything. And just for whatever reason, I fell in love with it. It's kind of been my way of fighting depression and keeping my mental health sane. So from there, combined my love for photography with basketball, and it's just been an insane journey so far. So I was actually at the University of San Francisco for maybe about a year and a half, and I just decided to like, okay, like, a business is picking up. I'm starting to get really good at this thing. People are really interested and I really like it. So I just kind of figured, okay, let's drop everything and just chase it. So for me, once I started, you know, picking up these opportunities with like, you know, different athletes in the area, being able to see my own potential and realize that I could do something super serious with it, that's when I really just like dropped everything, dropped out of school. Once I dropped out of school, I went to my first McDonald's All-American game. And the week after that, I went to Spain for Adidas in the Euro League. So, you know, as soon as I dropped out and those opportunities came in, I was like, okay, it's go time. Some of the people I've photographed and worked with, if we want to talk about companies, we have Adidas, Body Armor, Under Armour, Curry Brand, Slam, Bleacher Report, all these different guys. And then if we want to talk about people, there's Steph Curry, I've shot J. Cole, recently had the opportunity to get some photos of Kanye West, Aaron Gordon. There's a lot of people, a lot of cool people in a lot of cool places. So, you know, all the people that I grew up like really looking up to, you know, luckily I've had the opportunity to meet some of them and photograph them and, you know, tell just a little bit of their story and push out positivity. I would say the biggest challenges of, you know, just being a freelance photographer in general is the inconsistency. Like, everything is super up and down. Nothing's really ever certain. And I think that's super difficult just because, like, you don't know when the next check's coming in. So for me, the only way I really overcome that is by staying consistent. One thing that I tell myself all the time is things happen when things are happening. For me personally, I make things happen so that more things can happen. That's kind of the way I'll overcome that, you know, when money isn't coming in or like gigs aren't coming in. I just go out and shoot and, you know, go out to events and just network. So for me, it's like, as long as I'm truly making things happen, more opportunities will come in, the universe will align with me, the energy that I'm putting out, my own frequency, what I'm vibrating at. So that's kind of the main way that I make sure that, you know, things keep going. I guess another challenge was the pandemic in general. So I was just building up momentum for like 2 or 3 years, pandemic hits, and it's like, okay, all of that, throw that out the window, you're staying home. So for me, it was kind of like, okay, let's figure out what we can do. So again, it's kind of the same thing where like, as long as I'm truly staying on the grind, making things happen, and the only way to really overcome these obstacles is to like break through that wall. There might not always be a way to like go through all these obstacles, but you could find a way, and if not, you can make it. So you break through the wall, you go around it, you jump over it, you go under. There's a way for sure, it's just, it might not be so obvious at first. I think one of the main things that I think about is just be a nice person. When people come up to me, like, you know, they see a camera, sometimes that can be intimidating, other times it can be very inviting. And the thing for me is I just try to make sure I'm nice to everybody, you know, always having a conversation with everybody in the room, introducing myself, because I think one thing with social media is that we have all these phones and cameras, but sometimes we forget to be present. And for me, it's trying to find that balance of here's when I'm gonna shoot, and then here's when I'm gonna interact and like really have a deep conversation with somebody that's in the room and just like feel their energy and also give them my energy and, you know, hopefully make a positive impact. I think that's one of the biggest things, is just try to impact as many people as you can and really make a difference and be present, you know, be in the moment, like in this world where we tend not to be. There's so many different ways that we can see life in a positive way. Although it may be difficult, because it is, life is super hard, but we have all these little things that are good, and how do you appreciate those little things and like the people around you, and, you know, try your best. And I think that's really what it is. And as long as you're showing up every single day and doing your best and, you know, putting the energy and effort, that's all you can really ask yourself for. The advice I'd give to anybody trying to pursue their dreams, pursue their goals, is just start. I think one of the big things that people have an issue with is starting and like really putting themselves out there. And I think a big part of that is just out of fear. But push past the fear, like just start, just go. As long as you start and like really go for it, you can figure out the rest later. If you have a goal, you have a dream, you have a vision, just take one baby step towards it. Like, baby steps are better than no steps. So, you know, if you start, the momentum will eventually build up and you just kind of take it from there. So start.